Mel Juster. I served in the Korean War, 7th Division, 376th Tank Battalion. We had a wonderful day today, brought back memories, and very, very, very happy about it.
And who's your guardian today?
My guardian is Jeff Forrest and his girlfriend, Lake and Weed.
Hi, this is Jeff. Oh, we had an amazing day, another one. Can't tell you how much we enjoy doing this as a company, and certainly selfishly I enjoy it as an individual, and I couldn't have asked for a better vet as a part of this equation, so thank you.
Captain Tracy Johnson, Southwest Airlines, with Richard Falkman. We're very honored to be able to do this honor flight. Appreciate it. I'm also an 11-year veteran myself. So I always enjoy having military people on the flight. Thank you.
It's rolling out the red carpet for the veterans.
Oh, that's so nice.
Round of applause, please.
Eyes right, veterans. We have a group that is remaining out here to salute all of you. Hope you enjoyed your welcome into WWII. Was that a nice surprise for everybody?
We're here to see John F. Sterling.
Thank you.
I'm Lloyd Babb. I was an 82nd Airborne. I'm 72 years old, and I was in the 13th at first. When I went in, they were shot up the night they shoved me over in the 82nd. So I served there for 2 years, 9 months, and 8 days as a sergeant, mess sergeant. I trained people in Camp Campbell, Kentucky, and then I went to Fort Bragg and was discharged.
My name is Carl Furr. I was with the U.S. Army. Entered military service following high school in 1945. And after leaving active duty, I was in the reserves until 1953 and served during my time with the service with the 2nd Armored Division. Oh, this is a marvelous day, perfect weather. The memorials are just absolutely fantastic, and the honor flight group is just beyond description. They're wonderful.
Ray Galliani, 89, going to 90, Italian, and a real estate broker by trade from New York. And I never met such a better people in my life like over here. The people who sponsored this, got to give them great courage and credit, because if it wasn't for them, we won't be here, period. So don't thank us, we thank them.
I'm Bernice Rock. I have the pleasure and the honor of escorting this fine gentleman to this beautiful, somber place, which I'm very privileged to be a part of. I'm an Air Force veteran. I served in the Philippines and in Germany during the Marcos coup in the Philippines, which was a little interesting. Lost a couple friends there, but not nearly anything compared to what these guys did. So I want to say thank you to all the veterans who provided the way for us to be able to speak English in a free country. So my gratitude goes much beyond words for all of you here today. Thank you for the honor of being here.
Yeah, nice.
And when he plays, he makes the company jump into the bar. He's a boogie boogie bugle boy of Company B. Toot-toot-toot-toot-la-da-toot-la-da-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot-toot- comparison with them. The company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie boogie.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? I am Sentinel Bolt of the 3rd Infantry Regiment, United States Army. Card of Honor, Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. The ceremony that you are about is the changing of the guard. In keeping with the dignity of this ceremony, it is requested that everyone remain silent and standing. Thank you. Ceremony that you are about to witness is an Army replaying ceremony to be conducted by South Willamette Valley Honor Choir. It is requested that everyone remain silent and standing during this ceremony. All military personnel in uniform will render the hand salute, and it is appropriate for all others to place their right hand over their heart upon the command of Present Arm. Thank you.
learned very early on is that while you guys were serving overseas, you didn't have cell phones, you didn't have faxes, you didn't have telegraphs. So your mail call, letters from home were extremely important. So today, just for you, we have your very own Stars and Stripes Honor Flight mail call!
I'm John Thorpe. I was in the U.S. Navy, and I served during the Vietnam era. I was a guided missile technician on missile guided ships. And my favorite part was the Joey Chitwood stuff with the cops at the end there. It was an enjoyable day.
Llewellyn Bell, Lieutenant Commander. I served active duty 1957 to 1977, so I've been retired now 40 years. And not from working, but from the Navy. And I have had a wonderful time today. I couldn't have been with a better group of people. We were treated really like royalty. And it was an emotional day, but it was a wonderful day. And thank you to everybody, and especially to all the people that wrote the letters that we got on our mail call on our way back. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
My name is Ralph Kemet. I had a really, really great time today. It's just an amazing, amazing trip. And I thank all of the people involved so, so very, very much.
Okay, fine. I'm Levi Coulter, and I've been on this trip here with the gang, and we've been a fine time visiting all the tourist things for the veterans. Bye-bye.
It's Coney. Had a great day. Fantastic. Couldn't have, these guys did a good job putting this together. It's really fantastic.
Good. You served in what wars?
Vietnam and Korea. Yeah.
Great. Well, thank you for your service.
Appreciate it. Thank
Gene
you.
Yates. I'm Gene Yates,
and I served in Korea, and then in Japan, and then I was with the 20th Special Forces. Today is the first day that I had an encounter with the Honor Flight, and it is just spectacular. I was so pleased, and at times at tears, at the response of the people who appreciated our presence. Thank you.
This is Walt Beam again, and I was just delighted for the last 24 hours or so. I never had such a nice, everybody was so kind and nice, and I want to thank all the people that put this on. It was just what great. Wait a minute, 97. I had to figure it out. 97. Okay.
Okay. My name is Duel Mobley, and I was in the Navy during the Korean War, and after, I was in 6.5 years, and the primary reason I stayed in was because of the Cold War with Russia. I was in anti-submarines. We were concerned a lot about that then. I wanted to thank you and everyone associated with this organization that has put on this fine presentation and invited all of us to Washington. It's a day like we could never have on our own, and we all appreciate it greatly.
My name is Daniel Kampik, and I served in Korea from 1953 to 1955. I was in an artillery unit right on the 38th parallel, 155mm howitzers. I serviced them in the track vehicles that transported Four. Them also. It wasn't fun. Thank you.
My name is John Russell, but I go by Jack.
Four!
85 years old. Service time was spent as a veteran from Korea, and I was there back when they had the honey buckets and the A-frames in Seoul. So when you see Seoul today, it's not what it was 50, 60 years ago, trust me.
Myron Burgett, served from 59 to 64, was in the Cuban crisis, and was in the Navy for 4 years. Very well, I enjoyed the last part with the Tomb of the Unknown Soldiers. That was the best part.
Hi, my name is Morris Fasci. I served in the Korean War starting in 51. And I had a great time. Great guy here, took care of me the whole way. And I really appreciate everything that's been done by the people there today for us.
All right, my name is John Lowe. And I was served in the Vietnam War, and I was recalled back into active duty in late 67, early 68. Went through my training in Gulfport, Mississippi, and was then shipped out with Mobile Construction Battalion 12 out of Gulfport, but Mississippi. And I'll tell you what, this has just been a fabulous time of a reunion with so many of these individuals.
My name is Paul Malnove. I live in Jacksonville, Florida. During World War II, I served in the Army Air Corps as a bombardier and flying missions over Japan. I completed 31 missions to the time that the first atomic bomb was dropped. Unfortunately, we lost a lot of wonderful guys in those raids.
My name is Vince DeFerrari, and I served in World War II and Korea. In both times, with the same infantry outfit. And today was one of the finest days I've ever had in my life. I really enjoyed it, every bit of it, all day, especially that bus ride. Going along them highways, after them, with them policemen chasing us. It was great. 7th Infantry Division. Yeah, the Hourglass Division. Final present.
My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. And more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I did it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it.